Welcome to Vet Zone, where passion for animals, science, and medicine lives. Well, cholera me crazy for talking about cholera in 2018. Isn't that what my great-grandfather's dad had to worry about back when horses were transport du jour and the terms racist and two-ply didn't even exist? For 2018, the World Health Organization, WHO, estimates that up to 4 million people might suffer from cholera this year. On the positive side, the percentage of people at risk for cholera has greatly improved since our great-grandfather's time, and the risk for cholera in the United States is minimal. What exactly is cholera? Cholera is caused by the infection from the gram-negative bacterium Vibrio cholerae. Water that is contaminated with Vibrio is the most significant risk, followed by contaminated food sources. While most people who become infected do not show clinical signs, infected persons will shed bacteria in their feces within days. If that doesn't scare you, recall the last time you were in an airport restroom and witnessed someone who wasn't washing their hands afterward. Not to mention those individuals that use their mobile to talk legislation while dropping legislation. There is a saying that if feces phosphoresced, the world would glow. Are my animals at risk? This is one of those pathogens that is almost exclusively associated with people. With that said, there have been outbreaks in dogs, cattle, and bison. Most infected animals will not show clinical signs. When signs are seen, they are similar to those that we would see in people. And the risk of death is from severe dehydration secondary to diarrhea. In people, the diarrhea is commonly described as having a rice water appearance. Think of rice porridge. Where in the world is cholera San Diego? In 2016, the WHO reported cholera infections in 38 of the world's 195 countries. The high-risk areas are the Congo Basin of Africa, India, and Southeast Asia. The closest region to the United States that is affected is the island of Hispaniola, which includes both Haiti and the Dominican Republic. If you are planning trips to any of these areas, don't forget to cholera your doctor first, because cholera, like puns, is highly contagious. There is a vaccine for cholera. An orally administered vaccine is manufactured by three separate companies. All of them require two doses for maximum protection. Prophylactic antibiotics are not recommended. It does not appear to lower transmission rates and could increase the risk of antibiotic resistance. Well, shucks, can we cover the risks for cholera? When we look at high risk factors for cholera, we've covered travelers. When looking at commonly implicated food sources, seafood is the most consistent. With oysters being consumed raw, they are at high risk for not only Vibrio cholerae, but other species of Vibrio, such as Parahemolyticus and Vulnificus. The ardent worshippers of Epicurus, known as foodies, might also be at risk for cholera in the United States. While any seafood has the risk of this disease, foodies understand that some of the best culinary delights live on the gray side of Lady Law. The practice of black market food import at top restaurants is alive and well. Food that bypasses the FDA and USDA bring higher risk to the public's health with pathogens such as cholera. So enjoy some Beau Soleil or Blue Point oysters, and give a toast to organizations such as the FDA for keeping us safe, and to civilization in general for bringing us clean water. Clean water, after all, is the single act that has saved more lives than vaccinations, antibiotics, or even two-ply toilet paper. Thanks for listening, and see you next time in the Zone.